So there's a new emperor in Japan. Emperor Naruhito ascends to the throne after his father abdicated yesterday.
This is the first time a living emperor has stepped down in 200 years. Elizabeth Palmer is in Tokyo to witness the historic change.
The accession of Emperor Naruhito to the throne opens a whole new chapter in Japanese imperial history. It's being called Reiwa, which translates as the era of beautiful harmony.
In a brief ceremony, Naruhito vowed to stay close to the Japanese people and work for world peace. This is a rigidly formal world. Naruhito only escaped it once when he went to study at Oxford in the 1980s, years he's since described as the happiest of his life. In 1993, he married Masako Owada, a brainy Harvard-educated diplomat, and the whole country celebrated the newlyweds. But immediately, they came under fierce pressure to produce an heir. When the first and only baby finally arrived, though, she was a girl, tiny Princess Toshi. In a country where women can't take the throne, that just wasn't good enough. Rare public appearances project the image of a happy and casual family, but in private, Masako fell ill with depression.
Naruhito tried to protect her. I think she continues to be a somewhat more reserved and not fully healthy person. So I don't think it's very likely that she's going to sort of, you know, take on the new role with a great zeal or particular sort of, you know, with an agenda.
Today it was impossible to tell what the new Empress Masako was thinking. But everybody here knows big questions loom. The royal line is running out, with only three possible male successors left. It's known that Naruhito backs reforms that would mean that at the next ceremony like this, it's his daughter who'll be taking over.
Surveys show that a majority of Japanese are in favor of a change in the law that would allow women to take the throne. But at the moment, a conservative and powerful elite is still standing in the way. Elizabeth Palmer, CBS News, Tokyo.